This is the bicep busting muscle beach in Venice, Los Angeles. But why is it here? In 1933, an earthquake destroyed most of the gyms in the town. Oh, excuse me. So the athletes flocked down to the beach to train in safety. And this legendary location of the oiled up six pack was born. Okay, come on, 3, 2. Yeah, you're good, yeah, sure. Earthquakes are still a regular part of life here in California. And I've heard a story that your phone could be making things worse. So to find out more, I'm off on a road trip. I want to know, what are the chances of an earthquake happening while I'm here? So I'm going to give AXA-supported researcher Thomas Chartier a call. Hey, Thomas. So what are the odds of an earthquake happening over the next few days?
You're actually really close to San Andreas Fault right now. And California has roughly 10,000 quakes a year.
Hold on, that's over 190 a week.
That's right, and we are due a big one soon.
Okay.
And my research is all about making sure we are as safe and as ready as we can possibly be.
Great, nice one. Thanks, Thomas.
Good luck, Ray.
This is where I've been heading, up into the mountains of California, to chat to one of the top earthquake geologists in the world, Professor Kerry Sieh.
What I do is helioseismology. So I look at earthquakes in the past. And those ancient earthquakes tell me how an individual fault behaves. So does it produce small earthquakes? Does it produce large earthquakes? Then I can actually inform the communities nearby, here's what you should expect, and here's how often you should expect it.
Where and when is the next big one gonna hit?
I'm guessing it'll be here pretty soon.
This is an earthquake simulator, and it's used to help locals learn how to react when an earthquake hits. So does it look like a big one could strike soon?
To figure that out, we've had to look back 1,000 to 10,000 years at earthquake histories. We know that the San Andreas moves every couple hundred years, and it's now been 170 or so since the last one.
Ah, what I really want to know, though, is how can your mobile phone cause an earthquake?
That's a bit out of the expertise of somebody who looks into the geological past. It's more a question of how man can actually cause earthquakes. So for that, I think you better talk to Giorgio.
Hey, Giorgio.
Hi, Craig.
So what causes man-made earthquakes, and what is the connection with our phones?
Mobile phones and tablets use rare earth minerals, and the mining of these, along with oil and gas, causes earthquakes.
Okay.
The injection of high-pressure wastewater forces out the minerals, puts existing quake faults under even more pressure.
So human activity in the Earth's crust causes earthquakes?
That's right. My work is about understanding these risks so that our actions are much safer.
Awesome. Thanks, Giorgio.
Bye-bye.
Very, very interesting. Take that. It's for your own good, guys. Looking good. Yeah, lovely. Look, we need this. No more earthquakes. Thanks very much. See ya. So you might be saying, hey, Greg, look, I live nowhere near an earthquake zone. This doesn't bother me. But more and more mines are being built every day. So soon you might be. But the good news is we're talking man-made earthquakes. So we can do the research and change the way that we do things. And there are other ways to help. We can work with manufacturers to improve their recycling schemes. We can decide to not jump on buying a brand new phone as soon as it comes out when we've only just got the old one. I mean, smartphones are good to have, but they shouldn't cost the earth.